Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, and we love you. Thank you, Lord, for as we have come into one accord to learn, to know about you more and more. And thank you, Lord, that as we are keeping every teaching in our hearts, thank you, Holy Spirit of God, for bringing to our remembrance at the right moment all that we learn. And that makes our faith grow more stronger. Thank you, Lord, that as we learn now also, thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are teaching us, you are taking over, and whatever you teach remains in our hearts forever, so that we see signs, wonders, and miracles whenever we apply each and every word of God. By faith in our hearts and authority in our mouths. We ask this prayer in the most glorious and blessed name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Okay. So, we see people praying and rebuking the evil spirit in other people, especially we come across in families. Suppose if there's a spouse, okay, husband and a wife, and now the husband is really torturing or bad, the attitude is bad towards the wife. When the attitude is bad towards the wife, now the wife is in the word of God. When the wife is in the word of God, the wife takes authority to against that evil spirit who is operating in her husband. Okay? Now, I would like to ask some question. When that wife is taking authority, okay, and coming against that evil, yet she finds that her prayers are not answered. So can you please unmute? Can everyone unmute? Sister Jonina, wait. Can everyone, Mitsu, wait. I want people to answer me. Come on. Let not the same people answer me. Suppose if a person is rebuking, it's going according to the word of God, rebuking that spirit who is coming against her. Yet she has a complaint. Okay? Yet she has a complaint that it's not. Mic is making some noise. Can you please tell me? Sister Roma, do you want to answer?
Yeah. When she is rebuking the evil spirit in her husband, if she doesn't have love or she has a little hatred towards him, the prayer will not be answered.
Okay. Right. Anyone else want to answer? Yeah, you're right, Sister Roma. Anyone else would like to answer?
I did not understand because there was noise was there. What was the answer?
She said, yeah, there is some noise in the background. She said that when there is no love or when there is some type of a little hatred and now she rebukes, it will not work.
Yes, correct.
anyone? Yeah, Sister Joyce, you want to say something?
Yes, sister, the same thing that would I wanted to tell. Anger, bitterness, or hatred is there. And love has to flow from the heart. Heart condition has to be good.
Okay. Alicia, you wanted to say something?
Yes, sister. Maybe she has no faith, or maybe she's in sin, or maybe one of them. So she has no confidence in what she says.
No confidence. Yes, very true. Right? That is what we teach always. Yeah. Yeah, Mitsu, now you can speak.
What Sister Roma said is absolutely right. Faith works through love. And faith without confidence is also right. You know, without confidence, the manifestation cannot be seen. And also faith works through patience. The faith and patience go together. So, yeah.
Exactly. Yes, Sister Junina, now tell.
Yes, sister, when there is no love, it does not work.
Yes,
prayer does not work.
Yeah, we read that in 1 Corinthians
13:1
also, that if you speak in the language of men and angels, but if you don't have love, whatever you speak is only making noise.
Yes.
Like a gong. Right? Yeah. We learned that. Okay. Thank you very much for your answers. And thank you for unmuting and giving your answers. Thanks. So, when we now see the logic. Okay. The logic is, when we are in the Word of God and now we are rebuking, we are taught that you take authority and you rebuke that evil spirit, okay, and cast that spirit out with authority and tell it to go and fall in the sea. Yes, it can be done. The evil spirit has to obey you. But when will the evil spirit obey you? When you do not belong to his kingdom. If you are belonging to his kingdom, why will he obey you? He himself will be saying, hey, listen, you are also in my party. We both are hands in gloves. So what are you telling me to get out? So when that evil spirit actually knows, when the evil spirit actually knows that you are also wrong, now that evil spirit will never ever pay attention or pay heed to what you are saying. That's why the Bible says the prayer of the righteous never goes unanswered. But we need to be righteous. And what is the meaning of righteous? The meaning of righteous means having a right standing with God, our alignment with the word of God. That is known as righteousness. Our thoughts, our words, our deeds, our actions matter. It matters. Yes, we cannot be totally perfect because we are staying in the world. But no sooner do we go into a wrong mode, we understand that we did a wrong thing or we said a wrong thing and we repent. And when we repent from our heart, not only by our words, but from our heart, when the Lord sees that you're actually repenting for what you have done, there is where you get your salvation, the righteousness. So let us understand one thing. If we ourselves are going to operate in darkness, we cannot tell the spirit of darkness, now you get out. He will never listen to you. He will say, you are also my team and you are telling me to get out. How can it happen? We both are one team. So for that reason only, we need to renew our mind. We need to change our thinking. When we change our thinking, when we renew our mind, now when we, even if that person is coming against me, you know, many people, I counsel too many people on this, especially people are hurt when not only in their families, people get hurt even in their organizations. Literally, they get hurt in their organizations. And I always tell them, keep blessing, keep loving, keep a smile on your face. Show that devil that you are stronger. If you are going to have a frown on you, the devil knows that he has already devoured you. He knows that he has overcome you. Instead, you need to overcome him. You need to overcome the devil. So even if somebody is coming against you, not only in your family, even maybe your neighbor, maybe your colleague, maybe your best friend, maybe anyone, when somebody is coming against you, maybe a court case, we don't know, maybe a report coming against us. Now that is the time when we need to take authority and speak words of faith. If we are going to go into fear, okay? We are going to go into fear, or we are going to go into a grudge, or we are going to go into hatred, or we are going to go into, disobedience ourselves. Now, when we are going to go into all these categories which the enemy has for us, obviously, why will he listen to us? When we don't carry anything from the word of God, why will the enemy listen to you when you are already in his own team? And that's why many prayers are not answered. Many people go into frustration. I am confessing. They literally want me to give scriptures to confess. Tell me what to confess. Tell me what to confess. Yes, I do give them scriptures. I tell them confess. At the same time, you need to bless them. At the same time, you need to love them. At the same time, you need to forgive them. And if you can't do these three, then how can you expect something from the kingdom of light to come to you? Instead, we need to be compassionate on the people who come against us because they don't know about God. They don't know that they are getting devoured by that evil spirit. They don't know, just as the way we didn't know. Even we were in that category one day. We are not just new, born again, right from our birth. No, we also have gone through that life. We understand everything. And now because we understand, we need to give somebody else also that understanding. So we need to just be out of everything that is not of the kingdom of God. Be out of it. Be out of anger. Be out of hatred. Be out of grudge. Be out of frown. Be out of self-pity. Be out of complaining. Don't be a complaint box every time. If you are going to be a complaint box, you will be complaining the whole life. Anywhere you go, you will see something to complain. Anybody you see, you'll find something to complain. Anything you notice, you want to complain, you will be a complaint box. So let us avoid that. Let us see good into others. Many people, they try, okay? They try to actually speak. They actually speak wrong against others. And when I come, when I have to face it, I'll just keep quiet. If I find them actually, you know, speaking something out of the way for a person, like, you know, even to the extent of saying, let him also get punished, let him come to know, let something happen in his family. When somebody says like that, even without their knowledge, I take authority and I cancel those words. I cancel those words in my spirit because I know the word of God. They don't know. At that very moment, I can't say, don't say, wait, because they are not ready to listen. It's not the right time to sow the seed. Each seed has a season, but you can take authority and cancel every word, even if your loved one, even if your colleague, even if your neighbor, anyone coming against you and speaking something rubbish against you, or your family, or your children, or your spouse, or your parents, you just have to relax and tell the Lord, Lord, I right now take authority and cancel every word that is coming from this mouth. And I bless this brother of mine. I bless this sister of mine. I forgive them, Lord, because you didn't die only for me. You died even for them. But the thing is, I know it and they don't know it. Just pray. Just bless. I'm telling you, to seem a loser and to be a loser are two different things. The person who sees you forgiving, smiling, and going back to him or her, that person will say, see, I have won. See, look, she has to still smile at me. He has to still smile at me. I have won. She cannot fight me. He cannot fight me. But no, in the spiritual, you have fought the devil, and the devil has already getting tormented by you. The devil knows your value. I'll tell you one thing. The devil knows your value. The devil knows your worth. Don't let it go. Don't let it go. Don't give it free in his hands. He's waiting to catch you. He's waiting to get you. Don't give it into his hands. The moment you bless someone who comes against you, the moment you release your love to that person, the moment you forgive that person from your heart, you will see exaltation. The Lord will exalt you. Understand this. When we are into the team of darkness, don't expect darkness to go away from your life. Never. It will not go. And then don't blame the scriptures. Don't blame God. It is we. If something is not working in my life, it is me who need to ponder. It is me who need to sit with the Holy Spirit and ask the Holy Spirit, where am I going wrong? Why is it actually not happening? And then the Holy Spirit convicts you. Do you really love that person? Have you really forgiven that person? And then you get your answer. So let us understand this. This is a truth which we need to understand when things are yet going haywire in our lives. Why are they going haywire? What is the problem? Where am I lacking? Why am I not getting what I want? Then this is the answer. Love, forgiveness, bliss, compassion, surrender, lift up. And let God fight your battle. This is what we need to do. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for this understanding. Thank you for this love. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Even if it seems so very simple, it is not that simple. Thank you for making us understand in detail that why our prayers sometimes don't seem to get answered. Where is the lack? Where is the hindrance? Who is that hindrance? Am I the hindrance? Or is someone else? When I know that I am lacking somewhere, or I am hindering my own blessings, Thank you, Holy Spirit of God, for you are the one to convict us, to show us where we are going wrong. The moment I release my love, my blessing, my forgiveness, the moment I come into compassion with that person who is coming against me, I know and I know that in the physical, I look like a loser, but in the spiritual, I am the winner because my God is with me. I thank you, I praise you for this understanding, for this knowledge that you have blessed us with. In the mighty and glorious name of Jesus, and all God's people said, amen, amen, and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.